Hello friends, you are welcome to my channel. Today I will teach you how to make a health app. So let's start. So first of all, we have to log into x.thunkable.com. So first of all, it is very basic things like nothing is there. It's a white screen. So let me show you the first screen I made in this health app. It is first of all, you have to create new app and you have to name it like health app, and as your choice you can name it anything in your preference. After creating that app, firstly the first screen will show you water consumption. So this emoji, I will tell you about this emoji. So water emoji, like this it will load. You can see this water droplet. You can copy it from here. Like this, you can search heart emoji. This is just for reference. You can do it if you want. So this is red heart emoji. There are many others. So here, body mass index, doctor emoji. You can see this icon. There are many things you can search and you can get it from different websites. You can log into those websites and you can get different types of emojis. So while using the user, means it will be user friendly and it will look good and the user will feel very comfortable and your app will be nice. And that's just for reference. So first I will show you here. No column, I think. No, there is one. First of all, we have to add one column. This one. Oh, I need to tell another thing. That is in this water consumption screen. Water background image. Like this, you have to search. Let's say this one. You can do two things in Thunkable. Two things. That is, first of all, you can save this image. You can go here. You can upload it from upload files, or you can right click it and press on copy image address. Just showing. So you can do it like this, and it will be, the link will be copied in your clipboard. And let me show you what will happen. So here, this background. This water consumption. Here, if you enter that, the link you have copied, the background will be displayed automatically. So like this, it will continue. And let me complete the designing part first. So this is, I have added one row here. I will show you this one. First, let me show the column. I have to add one column first of all. There is an invisible label here. It's visible, but there is no text, I think. Yes, this one, it is text. How many glasses you consume in a day? Means glasses of water you consume in a day. So do you know what it will do? It converts the glasses of water you drink in a day, 2 liters of water. So how do I convert the glasses of water I drink per day, 2 liters of water? There are many there are rules. So let me show you how to do it in app. So here is a level, how many glasses you consume in a day. So you can design it like this. You can give the text color, you can give background color, you can like I have done it, it looks normal. You can do anything. You can make it bold. You can, there are many font sizes up to 900. You can do anything. text, I have set the text alignment as centered. You can set it as auto, left, right, center, justify, anything. That height and width you have to manage according to your text, what it will, what you will write. See, I am not deciding what user interface you will give. You will give according to your choice. You will give better than me, and like this. So you can see the edges, the borders. So I have set the width as 3, so it will be more bold. The border will be bold. The radius will be 10, and the color I have set as red. And the style as dashed, you can set as solid and anything. And change the color too. And I have set the font size as 20. So I will tell you. After that, I have added one text input. And as I told you about the hint. So here in the hint, you have to, means I have typed that, type the number of glasses you drink in a day. So this type the number of glasses the user will type. Like this, the user interface will be like this. Here is the command for the user. Here is what the user needs to input. Because if there is no input, there will be no output, I think. And as you know, the user will give input. And then one processing, that is our codes, will do. And then here in the output level, I will show you. This is the output level here. Here comes the output. So like this. So this is the text input. So I will show you how I decorated it. You can decorate it in your choice. Another thing, that padding as 15px, left padding as 15px, I have done it. So you can do anything. This is just for reference. So here border. So let me show you the border. It's width as 3. You can see the width. It's 3. You can make it 10, but it will look bad. Radius as 10, color I've set as my choice, and style as dashed. So now let me show you, because you know, after entering the command, last video I have shown you how to make that chat app, and I have given the example that if you're typing something in WhatsApp, you have to press one button and then will be the output, then will the message go. So this is the send, this is just like the send button. So what it is written, that what will it do? What will be the output? It will convert it to liter. Means glasses, number of glasses, the number of glasses you drink, means the glasses of water you drink, it will convert it to liter. So here is the text. Here is what it will do. And here is the background color. Here is the text color. Let me go down. I've set it bold, italics, and radius to 10, width to 2, color as this one, the border color, and the style as dotted. You can change it according to your choice. So now let me show you one more thing. I have added one more thing. That is, here I have added one output label. So do you know what it will do? So see, I have set the font size as 22. You know why? Because you know that font size increases, that means the font size of the text increase. Am I right? Isn't it? So like this, our output will be there. That I drink this number of glasses, X number of glasses. So convert it to liter and it will be Y. So the Y should look big, or else the user will, if it is like an ant, just an ant, the size will be just like an ant. How will the user see? How will they know our app is giving output? So let me show you. So here, this output level, I have set the text color as green. I have set the font weight as bold and font style as italic. So here it will simply give the output. And let me show you something more. So let me show you one new feature. Draw one navigator. I think I haven't taught you this feature. So let me show you how this works. So these are the documents. As I told you in my last video, that you should check like this, so you will be getting to know about the new competence, the features of Thinkable. X if you don't know about those features. You can see this menu. Do you see Amazon? I think these are the common apps. Amazon, Amazon.com. This is the website and Amazon app. You see that menu bar, that is a slide bar, like this, a snack bar comes like this, and you have the choice, you have your own choice, you can choose anything. Like that, you can see your button, level, text input, there are many things. So it's a menu bar. So how to do this? I will teach you now. So see, here, first of all, I have added the drawer navigator. Are you seeing that? Before also water consumption, I have added the drawer navigator. And inside drawer navigator, all of my screens, water consumption, body mass index, heart rate. Sorry, this is an extra screen. Heart rate, HW converter, that is height and weight converter. About the developer and reporter problem. I have added all the screens under the same category. You know why? That's because the menu bar, we are including the screens in the menu bar. Suppose this is home, about us, like this, the pages. When the user will click this button, menu bar will come. It will show water consumption, body mass index, heart rate, HW converter, about the developer and reporter problem, like this. So let me show you how the button works. We can just link, like I told you in the last one, how will the database link to that, this to that. How will they link? If there is no connection between these two things, how will they link? So this button and the drawer navigator will be connected by our course. So let's move to the coding part of the screen. So you can see the code is very small, just two blocks. One button, one click. Let me show you the IDs. So first, I want to show you the main output, the main motif of this screen, not our app, of this screen, the main motif of this screen, the main motto. We are just telling. Button one. When button one click, I want to show you some more new features. That is this is the output level. Let me show you. Actually, I've shown you once that this is green color, 22, font size 22, this is hidden. So when the output result will be there, when the output will be given, it will be shown into that level. And from output level, set text to, from glasses to liter, get text. Do you know what is this? Let me show you the icon. So this is the text input. Let me show you glasses to liter, and that's what I was showing. From glasses to liter, what the user will type, what we will get the text into 0.24. Then it will be converted. This is not accurate, I think, but you can discover new events and in the future. So 0.24 into 0.24, I think it will give the letters. So let me show you some more two features, that is this vibrate and this dismiss key. Let me slowly explain these two features to you. So this vibrate, you know, vibration, mobile vibration. When phone comes like this, you can see when phone comes or mobile vibrates, if it is in vibration mode, when message comes, it vibrates. And many more times when just we switch the mode to vibration mode, it vibrates, you know? So like this, we will be forcing the mobile. We'll take the permission first and we will be then forcing the mobile to vibrate. It will vibrate. Means like this. Vibration. So it will vibrate. After the dismiss keyboard, suppose in mobile keyboard, do you see mobile keyboards? Let me show you slowly. So do you see like this mobile keyboards? And do you see after typing something in WhatsApp, the keyboard also goes down and we can't see the keyboard anymore. You notice? And that's like this. The keyboard will go down. Dismiss keyboard. This feature is called dismiss keyboard. The keyboard will not be there anymore. And if you need the keyboard again, you have to again click on the text input, or else the keyboard will not be there. I hope you understood this. Now, I will show you one more thing. One menu click. So what is menu? I'll show you. So this button, I have named it menu. I have set the ID as menu. So like this menu, menu button icon PNG, you can search like this menu button icon PNG. This images, you can go to images. You can get lots of images. You can take any one of them, and like that I told you, right click, copy image address. You can do any of these two options. You can save, you can right click, copy image address. And let me show you here. I have saved the picture and I have got it like this. So the picture, you can see the picture. Our users can see the picture. So when our users will click on this button, what will happen? One thing will run and it will come. So like this, the menu bar. How will the menu bar understand we are in which screen? You will tell that there are sensors which can sense, and it will understand. No, it's not like that. Go to any components. You see, this is a new component for us, any component. So you will go to any component. You will find this option in screen. And sometimes it will be like web viewer. So you have to change it to toggle drawer menu in screen like this. It will be like in web viewer reload. You have to change this. Don't feel like it's not there. You have to change this to in screen and it will be like this. I think you all hope you understood. So this in screen toggle drawer menu, even you know, toggle drawer menu, it's not called menu bar. We all are wrong. It's not called menu bar. It's called toggle. It's called drawer menu. It is the drawer menu bar. Here it's drawer navigator. It's navigating drawer navigator. Toggle drawer menu. That drawer menu will be toggled. It will open. And we are giving the command here. In screen call toggle drawer menu. And here it will show that water consumption. It will tell it, we are in this screen. Highlight this screen and not the other screens. Now let me show you. So this part completed. Let me show you one more screen. It is body mass index. So I think this is a very interesting screen. Let me open it. So don't forget to close the screen. Today I want to give you one tip, that two tip, that is tips. So first one is, after like this, it will be like this, our blocks will be like this everywhere. So you can do like this, clean up blocks. It will be in the same place arranged. And one more tip, that is the tips. You can do like this, collapse block. It will look nice, like the codes always are here and there. I'm not doing it like this. You can to expand blocks. I'm just showing you. You can do this. I think it will be, I hope it will be helpful to you. Now the screen body mass index. First of all, before column, the most important thing I am telling to you is change the background color according to your own choice. See, background color, you can search it online, your hex code. If you are finding some color, you can't get that color, suppose aquamarine. You love this color and you are not getting this color, aquamarine hex code. It is not the color codes. Some people think that I'm doing HTML and here also it's like HTML color code. I will show you one more feature, hex code. It is like this, hex triplet. Here she will give this hex code and you can give this RGB, red, green, blue and alpha. You can set it. And the background color will change according to your choice. So this is one more tip, three tips together. So after that, again, you have to add one column. Here You're adding one row, that is the menu bar. So I hope I don't need to tell it to you again, and I hope you understood. So in the first screen, I will tell one more thing, that in the column, let me show you the column. It's for all the screens I have done it. Here you can see horizontal and vertical arrangement. You can change it. So it's like center in all the apps, in all from if you are dragging a column in the first thing, it will be like this. So you have to change it, space it out. So one more tip, four tips. Here, column. Here also I have done space around. So I have added the first label. I have changed the ID. If you want, you can't change. Okay, it's all right. Enter your weight in kg. Your weight. Let's search BMI formula. BMI. Okay. Mass by height square. Means it can, thunkable can't take like this mass by height square. So we have to do like this, mass divided by height into height. Let's simplify this like this. Mass divided by height into height. Like this. Mass divided by height into height. Okay, it's all right. So let's go forward. Let's move forward. Enter your weight in kilograms. So this, I have not decorated this screen. You can decorate as your choice. So this is the text input. Here the hint is weight in kg, enter your weight in kg. So coming the text input. So I have told about the hint. What is the hint? So you're giving that weight bracket kg, that everyone should enter their weight in kilograms and not grams and milligrams. It's not possible actually. And this is in kilograms, and enter your height in meter. So if anyone knows their height in feet or foot, they can easily convert it, no problem. So enter your height in meter. We just want the height in meter. We don't need to go to reference. How will the user search? How will they convert to feet or foot into meter? We don't have to go to reference. It's their matter. It's all theirs, and they will do it. So after that, here, leave this one body mass index. Here you have to click on this, and here is the output label again blank. And I have set the font size to 40. You can see. And I have decorated this. I have set the text as calculate BMI. I have changed the text color, width to 2, border radius as 10, font bold, font italic, and style as dotted. You can change it. You can design it according to your choice. The button is only button. No designing doesn't matter in the code. So this is the output label. So we can't name it output label because we have named one output label. So one thing will come, that your BMI is this. And how will the user understand? Let's make it more interesting and more user friendly. Then the user will be helped from this app. So let's the user will again go to Google. They will search, they will find, they will get, and they will get to know. And then they will, if they are just normal, they will tell to everyone, you know. So let's not do that thing. So hard work. Let's keep one image. Body mass index. So I have searched this image. I have got it from here. From Google, I have got it. This is the image, you can see. So this vector stock doesn't matter. So I have to tell from here. Body mass index. Yeah, you can search that body mass index. Images, PNG or JPG, like this, you can search, you will get it. You have to copy image address, you can do this. I have just done this for reference. You have to do this for making a good app. If you are underweight, if you are less than 18.5 in this text input, it will show that you are underweight, you are healthy, you are overweight, you are obese. Like this, it will show. according to your height and width. Both will matter, not only weight, that I am obese for just weight in this BMI, but also for height. Let me show you. Now, we know the formula, and I have told you that height by meter into meter by like that. Let me show you here. That level to BMI is a text that the output level. Level to BMI is the output level. The output level's text will be, that is the user's weight divided by the user's height into height. Like I told you, weight by height into height. Thinkable will not understand weight by height square. It will not understand like this. Let's simplify. Let's break this. Let me show you this blocks. Let's go here and there. There you go. So the main block first, I have took this divide slowly. Let me tell you. This main block is, you see, oh, there is something more. See, I've just forgot about that. With two decimal places. So actually there should be two decimal places. Let me show you this one. With two decimal places, not more than two. It will round like 3.1426, like this 1428 5612, not like this. It will just round it to two decimal places. So like this, in this you have to put this one. In this one you have to put this level to weight. From here you can get, you can see level to text input to weight, like this. Text input to it. Don't miss it with the labels. Just the text input. You can see here the text input, because I am telling you. Because I have first learnt it from my mistakes. That once I have done this and I was fully confused. It was showing null error. And that's why I'm telling. Text input weight means weight divided by height into height, and then we will show it in the output level. And two more things. At the two tips I had given you in the first screen, that vibrate and dismiss keyboard. So these are the things you can. These are the optional things. If you will give it, it will look nice. And I don't need to tell this again. That when button to click in screen toggle drawer menu, I have told this in the first screen, and where to get this from your in screen toggle drawer menu, you can get it. Now, a new screen. Let's start. Heart rate. So, do you think it's a little bit complex? No, I don't think so. So, yeah, first of all, drag it over. You can make this menu. I've shown it in each and every screen. First of all, you have to change the screen color, as always. Then you have to add one column. And so, let's set here also. The column, it will be like center. You have to set it to space around. Remember this, always remember this. First of all, we have to add one label. So I have written count your pulse for 10 seconds, and I don't know like this it will happen or not, but we are just trying. This is not accurate, but we are trying to make a health up like that. It will, you will need to count your pulse for 10 seconds like this in your hand or in your heart. So you have to count your heart rate for 10 seconds. And then this thing, you have to add a row here. And in this row also, yeah, here you have to set the horizontal alignment to space around. The horizontally. It will be horizontally space around, not vertically. It will be like horizontally. It's in the column, it's vertical and it's horizontal. Hope you understand like this process. So in this, I have dragged one button, start button. So the user will press this and it will start. Start. Text color. So this is just for let the user wait, and let's the user enter the value. Let the user wait for 10 seconds. So here is the text color, background color. I have named it start, radius 10. I have designed it like this. So here is a label. I've said the font size is 30 and the text as 0. I've made it bold so the user will be able to see. And here in this, this is the reset button. I have also decorated it like that and like this. So after that, I have added one more label. Select your pulse from the slide. I haven't taught you sliders. So let me show you this one. We are always familiar with sliders, but still let me show you. So I think server error. So let me describe you. Sliders like this, you have to slide and we will get the value. Let me show you the properties of the slider here. I have set the maximum value as 20. So the it will not be more than 20. The value will not be more than 20 because in 10 seconds, you know, the heart rate can't be more than 20. So as I think. So the value will be 5 means from the first that it will not be less than 5. It will not be means the person will be dead then. And the minimum value will be 5. The minimum value can be entered is 5. And the value is 5. So you can't enter less than it. And the step is 1. Step means if you are doing it 5, then you know what will happen. It will increase by 5. You are doing like this, just a small one. It is increasing by big step. Just let's see our footsteps. Like this, we are walking. Step, one step, one step, one step, one step. Not just like this, taking 5 steps. We have done it here, one step. So it will increase by one step. Just small, small steps here. And after that, we are placing one button. I think one more thing is here. Oh, this is a full row. In this row, I have set the horizontal alignment as center and vertical alignment as center. So this is label slider value. So how will the user understand what am I entering? What am I doing? What am I doing? I'm just moving the slider and I am not understanding what am I doing? Am I entering any value, any alphabet? What am I doing? So in this, it will show the value like 5, like 20, like 15, like 10, like 6, like this. I hope you understood. Here will be the button, calculate heart rate. And after pressing this button will be the process. And there is also one output label. In this label comes the output. This is the font size of this 25 and here will be the output. So let me quickly show you the codes. This is, very simple that let's cut this part. I will show you this one. The user will enter the heart rate. This is just for keeping the user entertained while waiting. So this is select your pulse from the slider. It will be just like sliding and it will multiply it by 6 into 6 and calculate heart rate. It will show the result, you know. So here, start. Let me show you from here. So I think the code is much more than the previous screens. So when button start click, we will know one more loop known as count loop. So I will slowly teach you. From timer level set x to 0. See if someone is entering, the user have already waited 10 seconds. And if the user forgets to click on reset, what will we do? We can't do anything. So before starting, just entering the start button, just pressing. If it is 10, it is 5, 6, no matter. It will automatically turn to 0. No matter what it is, it will turn to 0. Set it to 0. Wait for 3 seconds. 3 seconds. 3, 2, 1, and here we go. So the user will understand by this 3, 2, 1, and then will be a vibration. That let's start a vibration. So now let's see. So let me see the count loop. This is also known as the iteration, number iteration. No, it's not giving description. So this is a variable I. You can name it fan, you can name it sofa, anything. X, Y, Z, cat, dog, anything. Count with I. So this is the basic variable. I mean to use this variable. So count with I. So this is the basic variable. From 1 to 10 by 1. It is just like the slider. Count from 1 to 10 with 1 footsteps. Walk from here to here. Just 10 meter with 1 meter footsteps. Like this. I'm telling you. So it will count like this from 1 to 10. And it will increase. See. It will... The text like this, we can't do like this after every second, then the code will be much longer. I'm telling you. So after 1 second, it will be one. After 2 seconds, it will be two. We have to also show the user that you have counted it for this seconds. So wait 1 second, means after 1 second, it will be I, means it will count zero. From zero, it will count to one. Wait 1 second and set timer level to this one. Again, wait 1 second, set timer level to two. And you know how to do this one? After dragging this count loop, go to variables and there automatically will be a variable I. Name it, rename variable, name it sofa. You can see here, sofa. I'm just editing it. Rename this variable sofa to I. Or else it will be confusing for me when I will reuse this app. So it's up to 10. So when button reset will be clicked, the timer levels text will again be zero. So if the user will, I have told that the user will, if the user will forget. So if the user doesn't forget, if the user just pressing the reset, it will turn to zero. So let me show you that, do you remember here after the slider will change the value, here it will show that the slider's value is this, means you are selecting your 10 seconds heart rate as this, you know. So on every change, on every footstep, it will show you have walked this number of footsteps. Today we will walk 5,000 footsteps from here to here to there, 5,000 footsteps. We are walking with something here, some machines. On every footstep, on every single footsteps, it will increase by one, plus one. To make it short, we can't count if the user is giving 20, we can't, the code will be much longer. So when slider on value change, when the value will be changed by anything, any number, when the value is changed, we mean only by this when the value is changed. The slider's value will be this value. Drag this to here. It will be simple. So, show you. Well, this one. So, this is the processing. When button 3 BPM, I have set the ID. So, when this button is clicked, you know, you remember the level 4 output, that is the output level. The output level's text will be, you remember that I have told the formula is very simple, that this text into 6. Slider level. We can't tell that from here if we drag the value here. We can say the slider is changing and let's set the value here. No, we are doing this not only for the user health, that level, not only for the user health, but for our health. In this coding part, if we are dragging directly the slider to this, we have to set it in a variable. We have to do much more thing for this, but only a single level is doing multi-purpose, multitasking. It is serving the user as well as us, the coders. So here, level 4 output is equal to level slider value. You know this. Here we are changing the level slider values text to value. So here slider values text into 6, and it will display it in the output level. And here, button 3 menu in screen called toggle drawn menu. You know the menu word, I will not, is there, it's no need to show it again. There is no need. And the last one, height and weight converter. If you're using like CGS, FPS like this, you are entering your height, There is no button, you can see. I will show you one new feature, switch. You see switches while switching on bulbs, TV, fans, and everything. So, refrigerator too. So, if you're switching, you are switching off a switch, oning a switch. Offing, oning, offing, oning, like this. Repeated process. Let me first show you this one. Interior height in centimeter. Well, interior height in, do you know we are going to convert this in kilogram and this pounds in kilo, sorry, is this centimeters in into meters and this pounds to kilograms. Do you know this? We are going to convert this. Why? Because while calculating BMI, the user can't enter their height in centimeter or pounds, weight in pounds. So we are converting. After the user have filled it, it is much more difficult. It is not user friendly, but for still our learning, we are doing it. Set switch visible to true, but value to false, like this. It is not on. It is off. We are not switching. See, when the value is changing. So it is off. The value will only change if the user is owning it. This is a play of cleverness. So switch one on value change. When switch is on, it will first vibrate. If you are switching on the keyboard, it will first vibrate that and it will then dismiss the keyboard. That you can't enter something in the keyboard. And one icon is here. Let me show you. I've set the icon visibility to false, or else the user will be able to see it. This is the loading icon. Let me show you. You know the visibilities. I hope you know the visibility feature. That is visible true, then it will be visible, and visible false, then it will not be visible. So when switching on an app, it is loading. Loading is just for user friendly things. Visible. That it's showing that it is loading, and then it is not visible. After that, it is not visible. So when it is waiting, it will choose a random integer, that is from 3 to 5. You can choose 3 or 4 or 5. Suppose it is choosing 4 seconds. It will wait 4 seconds, and then we can't see the loading icon directly. We can see our answer. It will wait 5 seconds. Then it will be false, no matter. After that, then we are setting our answer. I hope you understood this. From text input height. Our height text input, set text to join with 3 decimal places. Now, there will be, you remember we have said 2 decimal places, there will be 3.123. 3.142, not 1428, 3.142, like this. If it is 1428, it will do 3.142. It will, or 3.143, I think. So from this, it will round it to 3 decimal places. It's all right. I have shown you how this arrangement is made. It will multiply it with 0.01. Centimeters to meters, we have to multiply it with 0.01. And then we are joining this text. You know what is, it is called concatenation. Joining to strings is called joining something is called concatenation. So it is concatenating. Join this. We are getting it from here. Yes. We are typing meter. So it will show this meter. Suppose it's 100 centimeter. So it will show your height is 1. Space meter. So it is not just directly we are typing meter. We are giving one space and then we are typing meter. After that, concatenate this with 3 decimal places. I think that pounds to kilograms is 0.453. We have to multiply it with 0.453 and this kilograms. And then this is the menu bar. And I have added this additionally that about the developer. If you want to know, means if you are interested that the users will know about you, then you are giving the screen about the developer. I will not go in that details, and I have given its report a problem. So you can, it's all done. So you can live test, or you can directly download it in your mobile and you can check it. So friends, if you like my video, please don't forget to like and share my video. Also, please comment something so I will get more topics, and please subscribe my channel so I will get more interest and courage, and I will do more videos, and really I will be making helpful videos which will further help you. Thank you.